Hello, I'm Dr. Arpitha Komanapalli and I'm glad you're watching this video. In this video, I'll be talking about the 7 mistakes that are made when it comes to washing our hands. Washing your hands frequently is one of the easiest ways to wipe out germs and reduce your chances of becoming sick by them. Germs are everywhere. They're in your home, in your kitchen sink, and on your countertops, in your laundry, in your shower, at your office. Even your handbag commonly contains thousands of bacteria such as Salmonella, E. coli, staph bacteria, and more. You simply can't escape them, but this is nothing to be worried of. It has been shown time and time again that washing your hands with soap and water can kill viruses that cause common cold, hepatitis A, acute gastroenteritis, and other illnesses. The effectiveness of your hand washing depends on whether you use soap, what type of soap you use, the temperature of your water, how long you scrub your hands, how vigorously you scrub your hands, and how you dry your hands. Here are the 7 mistakes that are made when it comes to washing our hands. Using bar soap. Pathogenic organisms may hide out on bar soap during and after use. Bacteria live quite happily in the slime of bar soap, but doing a few simple things will make it so the germs are of no harm to you. Rinse off the bar in running water before lathering up to wash away the germy soap. And always store soap out of water, allowing it to dry between uses. That way, there is no moist environment for germs to flock to it in the first place. If you're washing for long enough, the germs originally sitting on the bar will mostly like to wash off too. Despite this, the Center for Disease Control and Prevention, CDC, recommends sticking with liquid soap just to be safe. Using a refill dispenser. Researchers found that soap dispensers refilled from a large bottle of liquid soap in public restrooms caused an increase in bacteria levels in hand washers. On the other hand, not all refillable dispensers are problematic. Soap dispensers replaced with a sealed refill decreased bacteria in the same study. You may want to travel with your own little bottle of castle soap since antibacterial ingredients are common in public places. Choosing the hand dryer. When comparing paper towel or the hand dryer for cleanliness, paper towels are the best. A study found that using paper towels decreased bacteria, while warm air dryers increased bacteria. Warm air dryers increase bacteria on your finger pads and on the palms. Drying with jet air dryer also increased bacteria on palms and finger pads. Drying with paper towel reduced the bacteria on the palms and finger pads by up to 77% on average. Standard warm air dryer are actually more harmful to the environment than 100% recycled paper towels and cotton roll towels. To reduce environmental impact when using paper towels, reach for one towel every time you wash your hands in a public restroom. Joe Smith explains how to do this in TED Talk, How to Use One Paper Towel. In simple steps, he puts that shake off your hands 12 times, fold your paper towel in half before drying, and that's all, you are done. Rushing it. On average, people wash their hands for 6 seconds. However, the CDC recommends washing your hands for at least 20 seconds. If you need a way to time it, sing the Happy Birthday song from beginning to end twice. While it may seem childish to hum a song to yourself, it works and it's accurate. Improper lathering skills. When it's important to take time to lather, it is also important to lather correctly. These 20 seconds don't spend just squishing soap bubbles around your hands. You should really be scrubbing it. The friction created by your hands rubbing together helps lift the dirt and microbes from your skin. Don't miss too hard to reach places like in between your fingers, on the back of your hands, and underneath your nails. Skipping to hand sanitizer. Choosing hand sanitizer should be a last resort if you don't have access to running water and soap. Hand sanitizers can kill germs, but alcohol-based sanitizers must contain a minimum of 60% alcohol to be considered efficient. Alcohol-free hand sanitizers' effectiveness depends on each unique formulation. While purchasing hand sanitizer, be careful with hand sanitizers containing synthetic scents. You can find hand sanitizers fragranced with essential oils at any health food stores. Using antibacterial soap. According to the Food and Drug Administration, there isn't sufficient evidence to conclude that antibacterial soaps are better at preventing illnesses than washing with plain soap and water. Still, many families reach for these soaps. These products are no more effective than regular soap. Worse yet, the use of these antibacterial products over a long period of time is linked to negative effects. The FDA has taken some action against ingredients in antibiotic soaps. In September 2016, it banned triclosan and 18 other antibacterial ingredients. Antibacterial chemicals including benzalkonium chloride, benzethonium chloride and chlorhexidinol are still allowed in soaps. I hope this has been helpful to you and hope you will start washing your hands the right way. Here is a scripture to meditate on. He gives strength to the weary and increases the power of weak. Isaiah 40:29. As always, thank you so much for watching this video. If this video has been helpful, please consider sharing with your family and friends. If you have any questions or queries, let me know in the comments below. I'll see you again in my next video.